We have a very special guest tonight that's flown all the way from Oregon to come watch you guys, be inspired by you guys. I want you to think for a minute that I want you to 4:18 for mile, okay? How fast that is, okay? Our guest this summer ran six of them in a row. And he became an American record and the first non-African to run under 27 minutes for 10,000 meters. How about a 4:08 mile? Do you guys know how fast that is? I think all the guys here probably aspire to run 4:08 a mile one time. Our guest today ran three of them in a row this summer and ran 12:55 for 5,000 meters, which is the second fastest time ever by an American. He's currently training at Oregon with the Oregon Track Club. He's a graduate of the University of Wisconsin, time NCAA champion, Chris Solinsky. Who's all excited for tomorrow? That wasn't impressive. Who's nervous for tomorrow? That's okay too. I still get nervous for every single race I've ever run. So now, even when I was in 7th, 8th grade, high school, college, every race I'm gonna run in the future, I'm always gonna be nervous. So first of all, I'd like to thank everyone, USATF, for doing everything, putting on this event for you guys. Thank all the volunteers for helping out and making sure everything goes smooth tomorrow. And obviously, thanks to the parents because, you know, if I didn't run the Junior Olympics, but it's because my parents didn't want to drive me the 3.5 hours to the regional event. So you guys are really lucky that your parents and coaches are willing to train you guys for the event. So thanks to the parents for giving you guys here. So congratulations, everyone, for getting here, getting to this far, because, you know, it's a huge accomplishment this early in your career to make a meet like this, and you know, you get to be here with teams and individuals, you get to rub shoulders with a lot of, you know, best runners in the country, and it's an honor. You guys have obviously caught the running bug at an early age, which is really, really good. I'm a self-pronounced geek of the sport, so I love having young kids really energetic about the sport, and to take U.S. distance running to the next level. So it's really exciting to see you guys here. Basically, for me, I'm a very goal-oriented person, and you know, you guys have shown passion. And for me, I want to try to get as many kids from where you guys are to where I am now, and that starts with goal setting. And, you know, I wouldn't be where I am without goals. The red wristband I'm wearing has the words "dream big," and that's always been my motto throughout my entire running career. I've always set a lot of goals. I keep myself very accountable I write out a goal list. I still do that. I have it posted above my bed, so I see it every morning when I wake up. And right now I have my current goal that I just established a few weeks ago for this year, and that's to be a world champion. So I still do those type of goal setting, and you guys can do that too, no matter what level you're at, no matter, you know, if it's a small little local meet, small little local road race, or a big national race like this, you know, you guys get the experience this year and you just have success, or even, you know, if you don't have the race you want tomorrow, you can set goals to make sure that doesn't happen to you in the future. So, you know, I encourage everyone out there to write down your goals and keep yourself accountable and set goals, but don't just set small goals that you think you can easily obtain. Set those middle goals that, you know, if you have a great day, you can accomplish this. And then set those really high, long-term goals. Like, you know, I want to be an Olympian. You guys are at the Junior Olympics. I want to be an Olympian. And if you set those high goals, and set stepping stones along the way to encourage, you know, you accomplish this one thing, you might miss something else, but you keep working for something else. And, you know, don't be afraid to reach high and dream big. And that's, you know, the motto of my life. I didn't start out as, you know, a phenomenal runner. You know, I started running when I was 7th grade. I still remember my first conference meet, and I was second to last in a mile. And I don't remember what my time was. I think it was well over 6 minutes. And, you you know, that was like a pretty, I was pretty upset that day, but, you know, I, from that moment on, I decided I did not want to be second to last anymore ever in a race. So from that day on, I made sure I set these goals, and the next year I wanted to win the conference meet in the mile. And I worked really, really hard that next year. And I was fortunate enough to be able to accomplish that. And that was all because I set goals and I trained really hard and had fun doing it and enjoyed the entire process of working hard, having good workouts, having good races, having bad workouts, but enjoying the entire process all the way through. And, you know, you guys, a lot of you are here with the team, and, you know, you can enjoy that process with the team and work together for a common goal, whether it's a team goal or it's an individual goal. But, you know, just enjoy what you're doing, and, you know, out there tomorrow, no matter what happens, just get out there and run as hard as you can and have as much fun as you can, because you're only going to have tomorrow. So live it up and have fun with that race tomorrow. And, you know, put everything out on the line and enjoy with your teammates, or be there by yourself, enjoy the experience, and just have fun doing it. Know it's going to hurt, but have fun. You've trained all year for this race, so just enjoy all that hard work you put in before tomorrow. So congratulations on getting here, and we're all really excited to see you guys duke it out tomorrow and run as hard as you can, and just have fun and enjoy this experience and live it up. And like I said, there's nothing stopping any of you from being where I am if you set your sights high enough, and anything's possible. Good luck.
And they finish singing and you start towards the cafeteria, the Hoover